This is Indianapolis coach Reg Wayne, and you're listening to the For the Culture podcast.
This is the For the Culture podcast. I'm your host, Luke Diamond, with my man, Jason Spears. With the 34th overall pick in the 2020 NFL draft, the Indianapolis Colts select Michael Pittman Jr., wide receiver, USC. 6'4", 220 pounds, ran a 4.52 at the combine and had an extremely productive senior season, catching 101 passes for over 1,200 yards and 11 touchdowns, finishing his collegiate career with 171 receptions for over 2,500 yards and 19 touchdowns. He was named a second-team All-American in 2019 and, for the second time in his collegiate career, first-team All-Pac-12. The Colts waste no time in the second round of the 2020 draft, addressing a big need on the offensive side of the football, drafting Michael Pittman Jr. out of USC.
Very physical guy, 6'4", big, long, strong guy, great hands, catches damn near everything. He knows how to use his big body frame. He uses leverage well against DBs, especially smaller DBs. He can manhandle them. Like I said, he's got strong hands, large catch radius, so a lot of 50-50 balls with this guy, and most of the time he's going to come down with it. Really good blocker downfield, which, you know, our coaches really like about receivers. They want guys that'll willingly block, and this guy absolutely does that. He's got great bloodlines. His dad, who I remember as a running back, played 11 years in the NFL, so that's a positive for him. And his senior year was just unbelievable at USC. 101 catches, over 1,300 yards, and 11 touchdowns. Super productive year. As far as his get-off at the line of scrimmage, he gets off quickly. He's very agile for his size. He's efficient in routes, and he uses his body to create space. He knows how to use leverage and use that against smaller DBs. He plays big. Sometimes with big receivers or taller receivers, they don't play as big as their size. This guy plays big, has long arms, which we know Chris Ballard loves, and he's very tough and physical. He's one of those guys that'll give you everything he has for 60 minutes. He's great in contested situations, which I mentioned earlier, 50-50 balls. This guy's going to be a problem in the red zone, and he's got great hands. So, like I said, that's half the battle. I mean, he catches everything. He's got strong hands. So you can put the ball up in the red zone. You can do a lot of things with this guy. You can move him all over the field. They did that at USC to get him in mismatches, you know, so the Colts will be able to move him around, use him in a lot of different ways, whether that's slot, outside, whatever they want to do. This guy, you know, he can do a lot of different things, and he's very, very physical. So I think he's a great complement to what we already have in Paris Campbell and T.Y. Hilton. He's very comfortable going across the middle. He's not afraid. He'll go over there, catch the ball, take the hit. And he's very tough to bring down after the catch. Like I said, all this goes into the physicality of the player. Michael Pittman Jr. is a very physical player. He's very tough to bring down. So he does a lot of great things with the ball in his hands and without the ball in his hands. I mean, he does, you know, like I said, he can block once he gets it in his hands. I mean, he's going to catch it and he's going to do something with it afterwards. One other thing, he's a pretty solid athlete for his size. Speed isn't great, which I'll get into, but his agility is pretty good and he's got a little bit of wiggle. And he's tough to bring down after the catch. So definitely a great compliment to T.Y. Hilton. Going to add to our receiving core and a great start on day two for the Colts. Some of the drawbacks that I saw to him, he plays a little stiff and struggles to create separation. He doesn't have great speed on deep routes, but that's not really going to be his role on the Colts, I don't think. I think it's going to be more of an intermediate type thing, more of a possession type receiver because of what T.Y. and Paris can do. They can take the top off the defense. One of the things I noticed, which is odd, is he struggles with physical press corners and can be easily rerouted. So that's something he's going to have to work on. Obviously, we have a good position coach at wide receiver who's going to do, I'm sure we'll do a good job coaching him up for that. But, I mean, not a lot of negatives with this guy. He's definitely NFL ready as far as all the things that you need to be able to do to play in the league. I mean, blocks, catches, everything, like I said. And he's just a really, really consistent technician as far as receivers go. And the last thing he needs to improve on, and I think this is kind of a given for all college receivers going into the pros, very, very few don't need to work on this, that's route running and just varying the releases, varying the things that you do, you know, trying to make every route look different and not allow the DB to kind of latch on to what he's doing. But all in all, man, this is a great pick for the Colts. I like it a lot. I think he fits the offense well. I think Phil Rivers is going to love throwing the ball to him. And I think it's, like I said, I think it's a great start to the draft for the Colts on day two.